Welcome to Comscore Talks CTV. Over the course of this podcast series, we talk about the opportunities and challenges of connected TV advertising, helping advertisers to navigate this exciting channel and make the most of the new opportunities. We also cover the top 10 burning issues in CTV, from measurement and methodology to planning and programmatic options. Stay tuned.
Hi, I'm Jeff Sorrow with Comscore. I want to welcome you to our episode 2 of the Connected TV Burning Issues series from Comscore. Now, before we jump into today's topic, we're going to go ahead and recap what we discussed in our previous episode. Last time, we looked at what CTV is, agreeing on the IAB UK's definition that CTV is video content consumed on a TV screen delivered via an internet connection. We also provided definitions for the many acronyms in the TV space, as well as discussed why CTV is so important right now. If you missed it, we invite you to have a listen to our first episode. It's available on our website. Now, today, I'm going to be looking at the second and third burning issues of CTV in our series, which are how to integrate CTV advertising into the marketing mix and the differences between linear TV and OTT. So let's kick things off with how to integrate CTV advertising into the marketing mix. Now, fundamentally, CTV holds the promise of combining the scale of TV advertising with the capabilities of digital marketing. Granular targeting, rapid testing and measuring, and on-the-fly adjustments of campaign creatives. So how can advertisers sharpen their approach to CTV and permanently integrate it into the marketing mix? As we mentioned in our first episode, according to Ofcom's technology tracker from Q1 2021, 79% of TV households in the UK are connecting their TV set to the internet. In the US, as we presented in our 2021 State of OTT webinar, which is also available on Comscore's website, we've seen an acceleration of OTT consumption. Both OTT households and total hours spent watching OTT have increased by more than 20% since January of 2020. Connected TVs and OTT are no longer something that you can ignore in a media plan. From the perspective of an advertiser, CTV needs to be perceived on equal footing to traditional TV when it comes to its effectiveness on the audience. By that, I mean providing the same big screen audiovisual experience. Now, the upside is that it can also provide the trading flexibility of digital. Knowing that measurement is key to achieving the full potential of any cross-media campaign, the advertising industry is moving towards a recognition that measurement needs to be standardized. And fortunately, this has been reinforced through initiatives such as Project Origin from ISBA, which supports the WFA cross-media measurement framework. Now, this will also contribute to integrating CTV into the marketing mix. Advertisers need to be able to measure cross-screen impact, starting from exposures across a range of devices for full coverage of TV ads. They also need to know that their ads are being delivered against relevant and safe content based on true video and audio signals, and be able to access CTV inventory by targeting relevant content without compromising brand safety and quality. Broadcasters and publishers, on the other hand, need to be able to maximize direct campaign revenue with deeper contextual relevance and be able to offer brand safety safeguards with confidence to unlock previously unsold CTV inventory in programmatic environments. Comscore's CTV measurement can do just that, and it can help brands to better understand the impact of their advertising efforts across platforms and the extent to which their campaigns meet the established KPIs. But what about the division of TV itself? Do linear TV and OTT work together, or are they at odds? Well, it's time to look at our third burning issue, linear TV versus OTT. Do we have a winner? When it comes to home entertainment, it can absolutely be argued that consumers have never had as many options at their fingertips as they do right now, both in terms of content and in terms of delivery mechanisms. By mechanisms, I'm speaking of smart TVs, linear TVs, OTT, and so on. This is creating a world of opportunities for advertisers. One of the most common questions that we receive almost every day at Comscore is, what is OTT? And with over-the-top adoption on the rise, how do these platforms change the way that viewers of live content consume content from broadcasters and networks? Well, as we explained in our first episode, OTT is the delivery of TV content via the internet. Examples of OTT services include Netflix, Amazon Prime, and Disney Plus. Linear TV refers to the traditional TV system where viewers watch scheduled TV programs on a TV channel as it airs. And examples of linear TV providers include the BBC, or Sky, ITV, or Channel 4. Marketers need to have clarity about which content is relevant to be incorporated into which program, as each type of content delivers different advertising opportunities. According to Barb's establishment survey, 66% of UK households have access to at least one subscription-based video on-demand service as of Q2 2021. At Comscore, one of our recent reports demonstrated that far from competing against each other, linear TV and OTT actually complement each other. A good example is that 69% of those who viewed the crime drama series Marcella on Netflix also viewed it on ITV, which suggests that viewers are able to watch the latest episode of their favorite show as they're released on linear TV while also catching up on previous episodes they may have missed through OTT platforms. Another example is looking at viewership from August of 2021, where the most watched show in the UK on Amazon Prime was Nine Perfect Strangers. In this period, 56.9% of those who viewed that show could also be reached by targeting Emmerdale on ITV. This data demonstrates just how viewers' interests are reinforced across linear as well as OTT viewing. Now, importantly, for advertisers, this is a great example where understanding cross-viewing behavior is key to reaching audiences of ad-free OTT services and understanding how interests and themes extend way beyond platforms. So for now, we can say that there's little time to experiment and test these channels. The data reveals that OTT-only consumption is still the minority, but with more and more SVOD and AVOD services launching on a regular basis, this space right here is going to be the one to watch.
To learn more about how Comscore can help with insights into TV viewing behaviors, please contact us directly or email learnmore@comscore.com.